bill for taxation, legalization, and pretty much decriminalization of personal use of marijuana about a year and a half ago now. And part of the reason I did so was because I actually thought it would speed along the process of New York State passing a medical marijuana law, and that it would literally be, we've got medical marijuana before this crazy lady moves forward with actual legalization, tax, and finance. And I actually think that it was helpful that way. But I also put the bill, after discussions with many people, watching what was happening in Colorado and Washington State. We didn't have Oregon yet. We had some discussions in California. We didn't have D.C. That I knew it wasn't going to happen overnight in New York. And I thought, we can use this as a model bill that will evolve over time. We will discover the mistakes of other states and the successes of other states, and have a basically a educational working document that we can all be contributing into of what we think actually could make sense. I've learned a lot by talking to experts all over the country, watching from the states and going, oh, we don't want to do that here. In a perfect world, I think we would have a recognition of marijuana as having medical value, and having FDA and researchers get out there and study the different options, fine-tune what actual products look better for what diseases, and there would be a world of medical. And I wouldn't tax it, by the way. We don't tax other places. Same time, I say it all the time. I'm not a big believer in that people should use marijuana recreationally. I don't. I did when I was a teenager. The last time for me was 1976, Rocky Horror Picture Show. I was a sophomore in college, just for the record. Very similar to how we have successfully what happens to people who have been participating in the illegal drug market. In my bill, we would direct a portion of the tax revenue specifically to reentry programs, substance abuse programs, job training programs in high unemployment, low income communities to try to counterbalance some of those negative impacts that we've been seeing. There's so much more that we can potentially do to rationalize drug policy in this country, but I'm very optimistic that New York State will get there. I agree with you, it needs to be momentum building as if we were a state, legislator by legislator. I find it fascinating that my conservative Republican upstate colleagues, I'm sitting in the Republican Senate as a liberal downstate Democrat, and while they like to tease me about it, they keep asking questions. They keep raising the issue. They keep having quasi-serious conversations with me about it. And even though I've taken a bunch of ribbing for being, you know, Senator Pot, Pot Lady, my old nickname was Senator No Fun, because the Republicans constantly pointed out I was against their bills to allow children to hunt and children to race snowmobiles and children to do this. And I would always say, I want the children to grow up to make their own good or bad decisions. I don't want them killed before their 18th birthday. So now I've gone from Senator No Fun to Senator Drug Fun. So it's, but nonetheless, it actually continues to be a dialogue and a discussion because there's a bill to look at and to ask questions about and to organize people around. So I assume this is an audience probably filled with people who are more in support than opposed. I do think more help from the medical community and others. I still get the occasional colleague who goes, it's a gateway drug, and look at the heroin problem. And you have to go through, well, there are heroin problems, but it's actually been proven marijuana isn't a gateway drug in the way they think. But it's also proven, I think you have to be honest with them, it's a drug that many people should never be using because, again, if they have addictive tendencies, right, stay away from the booze and stay away from any drugs as much as you can unless it's for personal purposes. So I hope that this dialogue continues.
Liz, marijuana is your actual harm reduction drug when you have addiction problems because our senator apparently needs a little bit of education on the issue.